So it's the end of the Canada West season, and the Bisons had their year-end banquet. And I'm here with two of those athletes that got recognized there. These are the athletes of the year for the 2012 season here at the University of Manitoba. Addie Miles on my right from women's hockey, and Dane Pischke from men's volleyball on my left. Addie, I'll start with you. Your university career has come to an end. I'm sure it's a pretty kind of an emotional time for you, but you're leaving Manitoba as the women's hockey leader in points with 123. You're also the team MVP and the captain this year. What does that mean to you to kind of have all those accolades in your final year?
It's a huge honor. Like, sitting back and listening at the banquet and then people just asking me about it after, it's just a huge honor, and I've been so fortunate to play with all the girls that I played with here and to be coached by John and Rob and Lisa this year. It's just been awesome. It's hard to sum up, you know, it's just been great.
There are a couple of banners behind us that might be one of the big indications and one of your big highlights of your university career. Would you say those were your favorite highlights, or do you have a couple other ones?
No, those have got to be like team highlights for sure. I'll never forget Nellie Minchell scored the overtime winner in three overtimes, and I'll never forget being on the ice with her and stuff. They were huge highlights for our program, and yeah, they were just awesome to be a part of. It was great.
So what's next for Addie Miles now that the university career is over?
I'm just going to take some time off, sit around, do nothing. No, I'm hopefully going to get into coaching, hopefully try to get overseas, maybe play a little bit more hockey over there, travel a little bit, but for sure definitely want to get into coaching.
Dane, another great season for you, leading the CIS in kills, and must be a little bit awkward to be in Max Bell as opposed to Investors Group Athletic Center. Talk about the season you and your team had going to the Nationals, but not quite getting where you guys wanted to be, but still a very successful season for you guys.
Yeah, for sure. We played really well all year. We were ranked second in CIS pretty much the whole year, so we were feeling good going into Nationals there, and we had a strong group of guys that were all playing really well, and we just came up a little short. But I mean, I'm not disappointed at all. I mean, we came third at the Nationals there, and so I'm just really happy about that and really proud of myself and our whole team for getting that far. So.
And you guys aren't really graduating a lot of players either. You guys will be back just as strong next season, assuming injuries don't happen at any point during the season. Does that kind of give you guys even more momentum kind of going into what will be your last year?
Yeah, definitely. We lose one guy, our captain, Ryan Munn, so that'll be, it's tough when you lose a captain. He was great for our team, but we got another guy ready to step in for him, and we should be just as strong next year, and so we have the same shot or even better to win the national title, so hopefully we can do that.
So for a guy like me that's never heard his name be attached to Male Athlete of the Year ever, what was going through your mind when your name kind of got set out at the year-end bank?
Oh, it was great. Like Addie mentioned, it's an extreme honor to win something like that. There's a lot of great athletes at our school, and a lot of deserving ones. And so to win that was just great, especially with our season. So kind of just a great bonus to have. So
I bet. And so I've mentioned a couple of their stats, but if you want to know all of their stats, go to gobisons.ca. You can find out all their stats from the season, men's volleyball and women's hockey, just to narrow down your search a little bit. For Shaw TV, I'm Mitchell Clinton.